Good day, gents, and welcome to another episode of Road FS Detail Memoirs, where every week Rod and I get together and have some amazing fun talking to some amazing business owners, suppliers, vendors, and today is a huge day. A
huge day, because we get to talk to Chris Metcalf from Flex. How are you doing, Chris?
Good, guys. How are you? Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, absolutely. So this has been, quite a week for
you guys.
Quite
a week. April 12th, Tuesday, big announcement from Flex.
Woo! We had this announcement, on April 12th on a live video feed where, we basically announced that we're bringing a next generation power tool to the market. This power tool system is a 24 volt system that will be launched at Lowe's, in every Lowe's store, as well as online. So it's just a great opportunity. It's the next step for Flex here in the US and North America, and we're excited about it. The product's gonna start showing up in stores very soon, and you'll start to see the display, what we call display sets, going into every Lowe's store. I'm sure you guys, as well as people watching this, ask the question, well, what's that do with the automotive industry? Where are things going? Those are the questions I've been getting since this was first kind of announced. And, the answer is that, this 24 volt battery system that we're launching is a premium product. It comes with the Flex logo on it, meaning that it's a product that's gone through testing. And, during the live feed, we literally went head to head with the competitors and we showed the market why our product's a premium product.
Well, right? And it is quite a system. You got an impact driver, you got the drill. I mean, it is a complete system and I can't wait to get my hands on it because it looks like everything just fits super nice in your hands.
The bottom line, like I said and continue to say, it comes with the Flex, quality and the features that we have. I mean, just a couple of the main features that we have, 20% more power than our competitors, 25% longer runtime. And honestly, the most important thing here is the fast charging. Our standard charger that comes with all of these tools is 50% faster than the competitor's standard charger. And it's, time is money whenever you're looking at power tools and using them. So yeah, that's really what it comes down to.
Yeah. So I know one of the questions that people are having that you've already mentioned a little bit and that are going to have is, does that mean some of the other products that Flex carries, are those going to be handled in a Lowe's store as well? Or for instance, if somebody wants to buy, detailing products, are those still going to be handled the same way as they are today?
Yeah, I mean, it's not affecting our current market at all. The premium car polishers and those things that we currently sell through our current distribution network or dealers, that's not going to change. What we'll have is evolution over time. So we'll have new tools that are going to start to come out. They will be on most likely, I would imagine, this newer platform. But I don't foresee a lot of these products showing up just at the local Lowe's store. I really think that that line of things is more on the general construction side of things, whereas what we sell or what we have in our market, which is the automotive market, we just we see more professional detailers and things like that buying these products. So it's kind of two different things, but it is the next thing that Flex is doing. It's what's next is part of our new logo. So
yeah, and I know that there's a lot of excitement about it. I mean, it was a huge announcement. You guys gave away a truck.
Yeah, what's up with that? How come I didn't win? I won a Jeep. Why didn't I win a truck?
I put my name in as well. I tried. No, I'm just kidding.
I feel ripped. Maybe I'm taking the hat off.
No, that was something that was really cool. It was obviously enticed to get people on to watch. We gave a truck away. We gave away an entire tool set. Just an awesome event. So
Yeah. So, I mean, obviously the whole thing of what's next. So with, after a big announcement like this, what's next is just really rolling this stuff out and trying to enhance the existing products and the new product line. Curiosity is, what is the size of the battery that comes with the standard tools? It looks a lot larger. It looks more like a 5 milliamp instead of like a standard, like your competitor's 3 milliamps type of stuff.
Yeah. I mean, really, you know, cause the current flex cordless that we have here in the US is the 18 volt platform, which is standard or similar to the 20 volt platform that you hear from some of the other competitors in the market. And this new line that we're launching at Lowe's is a 24 volt platform. It is the next generation of batteries from Flex. And it has similar technologies that we have in our current 18 volt Flex products. You know, and obviously the question is, will I be able to use these 24 volt batteries on my 18 volt tools that I've already purchased? The answer is, for this first rollout, that is not going to happen. We don't have that transition piece in place yet. I think they're down the road on the roadmap. I definitely see that there will be a transition there eventually. It's just not there now. And you know, the 24 volt platform, it's just more power and a lot of different advantages over the competitor's product.
So you talk about fast charging. How's the life on those batteries?
It's really good. I mean, the bottom line, you know, I'm looking at a sheet here that just gives me some notes on it. And I mean, you've got computer chips that are in the battery that literally talk not only with the tool, but they also talk with the charger. So, you know, you've got just new technology that's really, everything is being monitored while you're charging those lithium batteries. You know, you do have what's called a 24 volt 2.5 amp battery. You have a 24 volt 5 amp battery. And there are some other ones that are larger. And the way that you understand lithium batteries, basically the more amp hours, the larger the battery gets. So that's really what it comes down to. And it does come down to weight too. So, you know, like in the 18 volt batteries we have for the automotive polishers, those are mostly 5 amp hour batteries, and those are the most popular that you see out in the market, are those 18 volt 5 amp. I think some people may have a 2.5 amp battery. We did a promotion earlier when we first launched the car polishers. So
is that, do you see that taking the place of permanently of the corded polishers, like the 3401?
I would say down the road, you're going to see the transition more and more to the battery products. You know, I get the question all the time, you know, the current, you know, XE3401, which is our most popular product that everybody recognizes, is that comparable to the 18 volt cordless unit? And I would tell you today, the power does not match the corded version. And I'm just being honest, you know, and the bottom line, there are huge advantages to having the cordless though. I mean, how many times have guys been detailing an RV or, you know, I know there's a ton of boat guys out there, you know, that I run across, and they're like, I just can't use a corded unit on this application. So your cordless option is literally the best thing that I'm able to accomplish this project with. So.
Yeah, no, and I think that's kind of where people are looking to go because, you know, as people are out there mobile, sometimes in, you know, in the forums and stuff, people are always like, do you ever ask a client to use their electricity? Do you have to carry a generator? Do you have a power supply? You know, a lot of times they have to have them. There's great options out there for solar and some of these things in there, but you always need to have some kind of power because you got to charge your batteries. And anybody that's used a cordless tool knows you need to have, I always have three batteries. I like to have two of the 5 amp and then one of the smaller ones. And usually the smaller one is just while you're charging, you know, and you swap between them. And that's really, it makes sense. You can go all day long. You don't have to worry about charging, but you want to have them charged for the next day or whatever.
What I would tell you is the typical system we sell, the 18 volt, you know, polisher system that we sell, it comes with 2 5 amp batteries. And your typical, you know, Mike Phillips is a good example. He did a lot of testing when we first launched this product. and he time tested every you know aspect of it. And you get a good 30 to 45 minutes of actual runtime. That's using it on the car. It's not just setting it on a countertop and running a stopwatch. It's actually using it on the car.
Right.
Our recharge time, since we have a high speed charger, it also has a digital readout on the charger itself. The longest I've ever seen on it's 48 minutes. That's from completely dead.
Wow.
So you'll typically always have a battery on the charger and one that you're using, and you always have a fresh battery when you come back to pick that off the charger.
Well, and realistically, you're not polishing for 45 minutes straight, right?
No. So. Yeah.
Well, I mean, the thing is if nobody, I think the hardest part is from somebody that's never used cordless power tools, and you know that anything under a load is going to pull the battery down more. If you just take a power tool and hold it in your hand, like you said, you'll get more than 45 minutes out of it, but it's because there's no load on it. The second you put a load on and you're actually doing something, then you're going to get varied on the time. So that's perfect. I mean, I've never seen another power tool that comes with 2 5-amp batteries. Usually they come with a 3.5, they come with a baby. You have to turn around and spend another $100 to buy one of the 5-amp. If you want to buy two, it's $200 or $300. And so you're doubling the cost. So to come with 2 5-amp batteries is fantastic.
Yeah. I mean, and that's kind of, when we first developed the product, there was a lot of discussion about how do we want to package this product? How do we want to sell it? And the bottom line, Bob Eichelberg and I, set up this cordless program at Flex a long time ago. He's since moved on to Lake Country Power Tools. But, when we first set up this cordless setup, we wanted to deliver what the user would actually want, which is, enough runtime, enough batteries to really get through that project. And it works. I mean, I've never really had someone come back and say, man, your batteries just don't last long enough, or man, I have to always wait for the battery to charge. Those just don't come up. And it does, it kind of brings everything to the table and what our parent company offers us with our battery system. And that's another thing that we haven't really talked about on this call. And, we can dive into that a little bit, but, Flex is owned by one of the largest lithium battery manufacturers in the world. So that's where all this technology comes from.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. And I think that's the thing is the Flex, we know about this, but a lot of people might not know. Let's talk about that, because the Flex company isn't a tiny company. You guys aren't like, Jody and I sitting here building tools. You guys have years of experience and years of tool making behind you, not just in the automotive world.
Yeah, I mean, the bottom line, first of all, we're getting ready to come up on our 100th birthday, and we still manufacture on our original factory floor. Yeah, 100 years, 1922, the company started in Steinheim, Germany. And, even when I go to the factory today, I can still see the original factory floor. And you can see, every decade that they added on to that factory. And literally Steinheim, when you go to any bar or restaurant in the area, everybody there works at the factory or knows someone that works at the factory, or their great grandfather worked at the factory. Just it's crazy. And it's always fun when I visit the factory in Germany. But about 8 years ago, we were purchased as a worldwide company from a power tool manufacturer called Shirvan. Shirvan at the time made a lot of power tools that you guys probably have in your garage or tool shed. But they didn't have their own brand. And what they wanted to do was buy companies like a good quality tool manufacturer like Flex, take it to the next level and have what they call a house brand. So Flex is a house brand for Shirvan. It's Chervon. Everybody thinks it's Chevron, but it's Shirvan. we have a house brand of Flex, obviously. Our other big house brands are Ego. So in the lawn and garden division, the battery powered product Ego, which is huge, one of the leaders in outdoor power equipment, battery technology. And then you have Skill and Skill Saw, which we purchased from Bosch a few years ago, all under the same Shirvan umbrella. And I mean, it just, the technology that they brought to the table really took our German factory to the next level. These products that we have from Flex still are manufactured on our original factory floor, Obviously, there are battery components that are made in our other factories, but that's the way the way all the batteries, all the lithium batteries in the entire world, that's where they're manufactured overseas. So, but we've put the best of the best in these flex items, and I'm so excited for them. And the demos that I've done with them have been so much fun because it's like you can't believe the amount of power that's coming out of batteries today.
They're amazing, and I've done a lot of stuff in the past where I've had cordless power tools since they were like I think 8
and novelty
8 11 12 they just they went up in size and power, and the old ones, they sucked really bad, but they were great because they were cordless, and you could do the things you can do with a cordless tool. And so I'm excited for it because I obviously very familiar with the Flex brand with the automotive stuff, but very and have had some of the tools in our hands. I mean, I've got some, the last time Jody and I were at Air Force One, we got to use the 18 volt polishing tools and as well as the corded stuff. And there's a big difference there. I mean, it's just the not to make it into a pun, but the flexibility that you have with a cordless tool versus with a cord is amazing. So
definitely. I mean, that's really what it comes down to when you get cordless in your hand. And I mean, I just can't reiterate it enough. The technology that is coming out in these cordless products today, it's not what, we had or saw, honestly, 5 years ago. It's just changed that drastic over the last few years and really made that big of a difference out there. It really does. I think people, should visit flexpowertools.com. That was launched just recently for this Lowe's announcement. And there's a lot of information on that website. And just go to YouTube. There's already a lot of influencers that are out in the market that are testing what we're telling people, which is that 20% more power, the 25% longer runtime, and that fast charging. On YouTube, there's already people that are testing those things and proving what we're telling people on paper.
So what do you guys have coming up for the rest of, not the rest of, but for the next several months?
Something that's cool for the automotive industry that we just launched was, and some people may have seen it on social media because I've already been hit up by text and Facebook and things like that. But we do now have a 2-inch backing plate for the PXE80. So that's something that just recently was announced. When we launched that PXE80, which has been the hottest item for the last year, people have had trouble getting it because we've had trouble manufacturing it fast enough for the market. But there's now a 2-inch. So you now have with the PXE80, a 1-inch, a 2-inch, and a 3-inch Velcro backing plate. So you can really have that versatility that you need.
Yeah.
That's what I need for my boat.
I have one. You can use mine. I have one. Every time I see Chris, I buy a new tool. It's terrible.
I know. How come Chris gets a hookup, but I'm left. Toolless.
It's all right. I got them all. They'll
be great. You're Chris's pet project.
So are you guys going to be going to any events coming up here soon?
Yeah, definitely. I think you guys I saw are also signed up for the Southern Detail Conference.
We're actually a platinum sponsor of the Southern Detailers Conference. We really wanted to go in with both feet and make this a huge event. I mean, to me, it's a specialty event that is directed 100% at detailers. I have no problem with other automotive reconditioning people that do wheels and windshields and bumpers and PDR and all that. They're great. Paint touch up. I do a lot of paint work myself. But to have a targeted conference that is hands-on, so I'm sure people will be jonesing to get to the Flex booth because I'm sure you'll bring some of this stuff with you and they can actually. Yeah. And I know from past years, that's why I own all the tools I own. Once you're at the Flex booth, you go talk to Chris and you're like, hey, let me try that out. And you get one in your hands
and you can really
see what it's like. I mean, I know that the smaller tools that I've got, it's nice. It's really a nice feel. I think there's a lot of thought that goes into the design and the ergonomics of it. I think that's why the 3401 has been such a popular tool, is just the feel and the weight and the way that it's balanced in your hand.
Yeah. I mean, the bottom line, I mean, that's what makes Flex today a premium product, is just when you pull it out of the box, it kind of sells itself. I mean, That's what I always tell my dealers is like, you know, don't say, hey, this is a $400 buffer. I said, pull it out of the box. Let the guy physically feel it. Because literally when he puts a flex in his hand, he's going to feel just the plastic and things just is different than the competitive products that are in the market. Or to be honest with you, since it is a professional line of products, it kind of sets it different from that DIY polisher. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think that's really what it comes down to. There are polishers that are designed to be used once or twice a year, put in your garage, and that's all you use it. I mean, I know some people that use the original XE3401. They use it every single day in their job, and they're not having to repair it all the time. They do basic maintenance like your carbon brushes, your switches, your speed controls, and your cords. All four of those things are like an oil change on your car. If you drive the car 3,000 miles, you change the oil. Same thing with your polisher.
Right. You know? Yeah. Well, and I know we've put them to such a big stress test. I mean, when you go to, when you look at Air Force One, that's six solid days. And I'm not talking about
not 8 to 5
minutes on and then off. It's
7 to 7
all day long, 6, 8 hours, 10 hours of polishing. It's not easy stuff. We're polishing metal. There's a lot of pressure we're putting on them. And quite honestly, other than, hitting an edge or something and blowing out a backing plate or something, that's not the tool's fault. It's the user's fault. We're using the same tools year after year after year, and then people take them home and use them on their job for the other 360 days of the year. So
yeah, no, you're exactly right. That's what I was going to point out, was some of the guys that have been on that project, with the Detail Mafia. I mean, I think 10 or 11 years, some of those guys, and I like to look at the date codes. So all of the flex tools have a date code on the side of it.
Yeah.
It's a month and a year. And I mean, some of those polishers are 10, 11 years old. And like you said, they use it and the polisher turns black. That's the thing, because you're polishing that aluminum. It just gets so dirty. And I'm like, do you guys want me to give you a new polisher? I appreciate, you using it. And they always, no, I've been using the same polisher for 10 years, and they specifically want to make sure it stays dirty. And they show their customers and things like that, hey, I work hard. This is what my equipment, this one was used specifically on Air Force One, and now we're detailing your car with it, So they use that in their local marketing.
Yeah, I know. That's awesome. So give us the goodies. Where can people find the new power tools? And hit the store?
So they will start rolling out any time now in the individual markets. The product's already in the U.S. in our warehouse. And I don't have the exact number of tools that'll be set at each Lowe's store, but it's in the 20 plus, for the original rollout. And that means you'll have an entire display that is the Flex branded display with all of those 20 plus tools on display there that you'll be able to. Some of the stores will have live demos where you can put the tool and actually, drill some screws and things like that. But flexpowertools.com is where you can visit to get more information on it. And I can't reiterate that enough, just to go there and see some of the offerings that are out there. Definitely in the detail market, there will be guys that are interested in things like, your standard drill for your wheel whirlies and all of those different areas, carpet brushes, can put on those different drills. So some of this stuff will roll into some of the automotive dealers that already carry Flex eventually. So you'll start to see more of that popping up, but this is our first, big rollout, and it's not going to stop. I'll tell you that the roadmap is very, very full going to 2025. So
I'm super excited for it. I was super excited when I started seeing the ads. About a week ago, I started seeing some kind of flashes of it and kind of anticipated what was going on. But I can't wait to get my hands on one and just see the difference in them. I mean, it's awesome. And, we've already got the stickers in the hat. So,
That's right, man.
We're already in there. My tattoo comes next week.
I'll tell you, that hat you're wearing, Jody, is like one of those classic hats that came from Germany. Someone was wearing it. Actually, I think it was during one of Rennie's road trips over to Germany. someone saw that and it just kind of blew up. Everybody was asking for the big block hat, you know, the flat bill. I'm not a flat bill guy.
I'm not either.
No.
I tried to put it on.
You tried to move it
yeah,
a little bit.
Yeah, I tried to do that. My wife's like, the flat bill, you look dumb.
I do it. I don't even fake it. I take the hat and bend it all in. My hats are like this anyway.
So you got the
blocked out hat.
That's right.
No, that's good, man. Well, we're super excited for Flex. I mean, this is a huge thing. Congratulations to the winner of the truck. I'm still bummed. I guess I didn't slip you enough in the backside, you know, it's all good. Congratulations. And we're super excited to see you at the Southern Detailers Conference. Rod and I are going to be doing live episodes all day,
every day.
So we'll need to get you on. We're going to have a schedule, line people up. You'll be able to show the tools and just have a great conversation. We're really excited. We're counting down the days. If you haven't gotten your tickets, make sure you go out, get your tickets, get your reservations, your accommodations, because it's going to be a packed house.
Yeah, it's huge. The event facility is huge. It's one of the reasons I'm so excited about it. It's like over 100,000 square feet of building. They've opened up the entire new convention center. And I think we are the first event in the convention center. It's a brand new convention center. It is, you know, with all the crap that happened last year, it is setting itself up to be such a great event. So I can't wait to be there, see you, see the Flex booth, see all the new stuff that's rolling out. And just, it sounds like it's going to be an awesome time.
Yeah. I just recently, you know, made my final payment to the group over at Southern Detail Conference. You know, Daryl obviously is a key person that started this show. And, you know, he told me, he's like, they gave us a little bit larger space, so we're able to stay spread out, which I thought was key. So I'm not sure exactly the layout, but I don't think all the booths are going to be like side by side, like at a standard show. I think he's trying to spread things out a little bit, which will be good for all of us. You know, 'cause there will be some limitations and things like that, but the bottom line, everybody I've talked to that's within an 8 to 10 hour drive to Lexington's coming. Because to be honest with you, I think everybody's antsy and ready to kind of get out into the wild. I've already had my vaccination, so you know, I'm good to go there. I know that's controversial, so we're not going to get into that. But you know, it is what it is. You know, I made it through the vaccination, you know, with a few chills and things like that. But it's all good, and I feel comfortable now when I travel.
You didn't grow a third eye, so we're good.
I'm good. I'm all good.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. You guys that are tuning in every week, thank you so much. Every week, we appreciate your support. Remember to like, subscribe, and use the hashtags Buff and Shine Manufacturing, Reflection Artists, and RotaFest to be part of our 2021 Business Enhancement Giveaway. And, of course, make sure to see us at the Southern Detailers Conference with our good friend, Chris Metcalf. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you guys next time.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
All right. See ya.